Great is your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's heart. You lead us by still waters into mercy. And nothing can keep us apart. So remember your people, remember your children, remember your promise, oh God. Your grace is enough, your grace is enough, your grace is enough. Great is your love and justice, God. You use the weak to lead the strong. You lead us in the song of your salvation. And all your people sing along.
Everybody, you probably noticed things look a little bit different tonight, and there's a reason for that. Let me share. I think many of you probably know Pastor Michael went to Idaho to spend some time with his brother who's been in hospice. His brother is still with us, but it was quite a whirlwind of lots of traveling, lots of airports, lots of layovers, lots of driving, lots of rental cars. But the blessing is that his brother's conscious, he's alert. Pastor Michael got to spend some great quality time with him. They watched a football game together and got to see a lot of his family. But all that to say, he needs some rest, and we need to pray for our pastor and his family. Recent neck surgery, of course, and his voice. So his neck is hurting from all the traveling, and his voice is a little shot. So keep him in prayer. We're going to pray for him now, actually. But also, we just learned tonight that Pastor Mike Lynn's brother, Dave, was in a bad car accident, and and rolled the car, and he's currently in ICU with a brain bleed. And we just found this out. He actually just found this out this evening or today. So let's pray for them now, and we're going to continue our time of worship. So tonight is going to be an evening of worship and prayer. And please, just lots to pray about, you know, both all globally, nationally, individually, personally. And but we have a God in heaven who loves us, and he's in tune and attentive to every detail of our lives. Amen? Amen. Let's pray. Father God, we lift up our pastors to you, Pastor Michael and Pastor Mike, and what their families are experiencing. We thank you for Pastor Michael and the opportunity you gave him to spend some great time with his brother and family these last several days. Be with his brother as he's hanging on, Lord, and until you decide to call him home. And we thank you that they got to spend time together watching a football game and laughing and enjoying each other's company. And Pastor Michael just having that opportunity to love on his family. And Father, we lift up Pastor Mike and his brother Dave in this situation that just came as such a shock today. We pray that you would stop the brain bleed, Father. You created him in his mother's womb. You have full control over every fiber, every cell in his body, Father. So we pray for a miracle that you would intervene and supernaturally. We also pray for the doctors that you give them wisdom, discernment, help them guide their hands, guide their thoughts, guide the information that they're contemplating and factoring into these decisions. And we just pray that for your Holy Spirit to lead them, guide them, and that he would be fully restored and out of the hospital, back with his family. We lift up his family, that you would be with them as well, as they're obviously concerned. And just pray that you would use this opportunity to draw him and everyone else to you. And ultimately, as we always pray through all of these situations, that you would be glorified, your greatness, your goodness, your love, and your mercy would shine through. We commit it all to you. In Jesus' name we pray.
I sing praises to your name. Praises to your name. The name that's so much higher than all names. And all honor to your name. Honor to your name. The name that's so much greater than all.
Every voice, let's lift it up to the Father.
Be lifted up. Be lifted higher. Be lifted up. Be lifted high. I sing praises to your name. Praises to your name. The name that's so much higher than all names.
All honor.
And all honor to your name. Honor to your name, the name that's so much greater than all names. Oh, 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 oh. Be lifted up. Be lifted high. life. Your name is hope inside me, hope inside me. Your name is love, a love that always finds me, always finds me. Your name is life, your name is hope inside me, hope inside me.
Your name is love.
Your name is love, a love that always finds me, always finds me.
Let's sing that again.
Your name is life, your name is hope inside me, hope inside me. Your name is love, a love that always finds me, always finds me. Be lifted up, be lifted higher, be lifted.
Merciful Savior, precious Redeemer, a friend, a father, a provider, the Lamb of God who took away the sins of the world. Savior, precious Redeemer and friend. Who would have thought that a Lamb
Fills the night, it cannot hide the light. Whom shall I fear? You crush the enemy underneath my feet. You are my sword and shield, though darkness lingers still. Whom shall I fear? I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. My strength is in your name, for you alone can save. You will deliver me, yours is the victory. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I fear? I know who goes before me, I know who stands behind. Is always by my side, the one who reigns forever. He is a friend of mine, the God of angel armies is always by my side. Nothing formed against me shall stand. You hold the whole world in your hand. I'm I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The one who reigns forever, he is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. I know who goes before me. I know who stands behind. Always by my side, the one who reigns forever. He is a friend of mine. The God of angel armies is always by my side. The God of angel armies is always by my side.
Amen. You all may be seated. We're going to have the ushers to come forward. We're going to receive this evening's tithes and offerings as I pray for the offering, and then we will just share a couple announcements before we continue a time of worship. Heavenly Father, we thank you for an opportunity to give back to you what's rightfully yours. Everything is yours. The breath we're breathing right now, the heartbeats in our chests, our very lives, Father, and with that, our provision, our blessings, our jobs, it all comes from you. So, Father, we pray that you would receive these tithes, these offerings, for your kingdom, for your glory, for your honor, for your purpose. And help us all to be good stewards with them. And we just pray that you would multiply them and bless the giver, we ask. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hey, we got just a few announcements. Trendsetters, it's Bible study is tomorrow morning at 10:30, guys. Please be sure, men and women, I'm forgetting this is a men's and women's study. So if you're free tomorrow morning, 10:30, please come join. Our very own Steve Gordon is going to be teaching tomorrow morning. Hunter will be there leading worship, so it should be a great blessed time of worship and time in the Word and iron sharpening iron, praying for each other. 10:30 tomorrow morning. Also, the first New Believers Bible study was last night. There are two more planned for Tuesday, October 15th and October 22nd. I know I'm running through a lot of this, but of course you can always stop at the information center desk, get you on your way out and get more information. Even if you miss this first New Believers Bible study, you can still attend. It starts at 6:30 in room 8. And there's one more announcement. I'm going to invite Cindy to come on up here. Look, she was there and ready. Everybody give a welcome to Cindy. Cindy's going to come on up and just share one more announcement pertaining to a women's ministry opportunity. Cindy?
Hello, church family. The women's ministry wanted to extend an invitation to the whole church to the prayer walk that we're having on October 19th. We want to see all of you there, not just the women's ministry. It's the second one that we've had, and the first one was really special. We met out by the gym, the kids' gym, jungle gym out there by the tree, and we started with a prayer, a group prayer, and then we all kind of just walked out and in all different directions throughout the campus. We had little prayer cards that you could choose and take with you if you wanted, and we literally planted scripture in the ground of this campus as we walked through. And everybody just kind of went wherever their heart led them and prayed all throughout the campus. And we just want to invite the entire church.
Thanks. Thank you, Cindy. Amen. And we're going to pray one more time. Esther is going to lead us. You know, the East Coast is being pummeled, as you know. And with the two hurricanes, one they're still recovering from and another one hitting as we speak. So what a divine time to be worshiping and praying right now while the people need this on the East Coast in Florida. And in case anyone's interested or anyone's been thinking about it and concerned, Tomas and his family, who, of course, moved there recently, I texted him yesterday morning. He responded this morning. They're safe. They're fine. They're far enough south in Florida that they're getting rain, but they're not in the danger zone. So praise the Lord for that. He was happy to hear from us, and they're safe. But with that, I'm going to invite Esther to pray for those folks.
Amen. Let's bow our heads and intercede for the people that are in harm's way or maybe affected by this hurricane. Father, we thank you that we can come boldly to your throne because of your grace, Lord. We thank you that we can come, Lord, and your word says that we may cast our fears and our worries and our burdens upon you, for you care. And Father, tonight we stand in intercession for our fellow Americans, Lord, that are being affected and that are going to be affected, Lord. We pray that you show your hand, Lord, of mercy. We're reminded, Lord, of a time where you yourself, along with your disciples, faced a storm. And you reminded your disciples of their faith. Father, and your word says that you spoke to the winds and you spoke to the oceans and you said, be still. Father, the oceans, the winds, and nature still knows your name. We speak in favor, Lord, of everyone, Lord, that is in the area, our brothers and sisters. Father, we also ask for Wyoming, which is there's a major fire taking place. 73,000 acres are burning, Lord. Father, have mercy. Our world needs you so badly. The people that are being displaced and are losing their homes and families. Father, have mercy. We need you.
Yes, Lord.
Have mercy on our country. We ask for mercy. We thank you for everyone here. And we just thank you, Lord. We lift up your name. We thank you, Father. You hear our prayers.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for your goodness, Father, and for your presence in this place. Amen.
Lord, I come, I confess, bowing here, I find my rest, and without you, I fall apart, and you're the one that guides my Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh, God, how I need you. Well, sin runs deep, your grace is more. Where grace is found is where you are. And where you are, Lord, I am free. Holiness in Christ in me is where you are. Lord, I am free. Holiness is Christ in me. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My temptation comes my way, when I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. When I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Oh, Jesus, you're my hope and stay.
Stand up together and declare this one more time. Come on, sing it out.
Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one. Middle of the storm.
Church, you can all go ahead and grab a seat one more time. You know, I've been asked to pray for our nation as a whole, these upcoming elections. And, you know, before service, I was thinking, I didn't have something prepared that I was going to say, but I prayed that the Lord would, you know, give me something, just something that might need to be prayed or said in this moment. And that he would verify it, you know, like give me a sign that's like, okay, if you give me something, then can you let me know it's like what you want me to say? And the word that came to me backstage, just one word, a word for our people. You know, I think about the nation. I think about, of course, everybody. But those of us here, this body of believers in this room right now, like a word, like what's something that the Lord wants me to say? Maybe, right? I was praying. The word that he gave me, though, was rest. Just one word, rest. And in terms of validation of something like that, that became a theme that I wasn't expecting this already to go. You know, of course, my dad opening the service, praying for our pastors, families, and just with our Pastor Michael, and specifically just that we pray that he would be rested tonight, right? And then the other thing was the passage. I even had it open right here as we got into this service, and it's the same passage that Esther brought up, which was Matthew 8, referring to Jesus sleeping on the boat, but then calming the seas, calming the storms with his voice. And I know there's so much you can pull out of that passage. There's so much there. But the message that stood out to me was that the storm was there. And this is not just a literal storm, of course, that we are praying for in the situation, but there's a political storm too, right? There's a lot of storm and trouble and chaos in our world, in our nation. And that storm was present, and Jesus was sleeping. He was resting. And we weren't. And that's not to say that we're supposed to stop, you know, what we're doing. We're supposed to just ignore things. But we're in the boat with Jesus. You know, we're in the boat with the person who has control over all of the storms of life. And that's a call, really, to rest. That's a motivating, restful thought, not a restless thought. You know, when the disciples said, "Lord, save us, we will drown," you know, how often are we screaming that, right? For many reasons. And he said, "Why are you afraid?" And so he calls us to enter into his rest. And again, it's not to say that we don't do our part, but we do it from a place of rest, trusting and anchored in the Lord. And I think that's the key here. And so I do want to pray for our nation and all that's happening right now. God, we rest in you. We recognize what's at stake, but one thing that's not at stake is that you're always on the throne, and we can, again, trust that you're in charge of everything, and you know what's going on. You have a plan in any circumstance. And at the same time, you've called us to do a lot of things. You've called us to make awareness about issues. You've called us to, I believe, step out and vote because we have a voice to do so. And the things that you would put on our hearts, of course, the things that are pleasing to you, I pray we would vote with that in mind. And whoever becomes elected, that they would be molded and shaped by you, that they would seek you, that you would change things in ways that we never saw coming. Think about on Sunday, we prayed how we sang that you're the way maker and that you're working even when we don't see it. And I could think of a lot of circumstances and events that can play out where we don't necessarily see it. But you're still the way maker. You're the miracle worker. And so, again, we trust in you. We pray for the healing of our land. We pray for the decision makers. We pray for the body of believers to step out and do their part, and also to pray. I pray that we would all pray. And we thank you for the blessing of being here, the blessing that we actually have in this country to be here right now, praying to you, and that we're on the internet right now because of it. We're everywhere vocally. People can hear us, and that's still a miracle, Lord. And so we're thankful for that good news. Ultimately, Lord, that you would be glorified through it all. We've seen what you can do, O God of wonders. Your power has no end. The things you've done before, in greater measure, you will do again. 'Cause there's no prison wall you can't break through, no mountain you can move. All things are possible. You believe it? And there's no broken body you can raise, no soul that you can't save. All things are possible. The darkest night, you can light it up. You can light it up. You're the God of revival. Let hope arise and death is overcome. You've already won, the God of revival. You rose in victory, and now you're seated forever on your throne.
So why should my heart fear?
So why should my heart fear what you've defeated? I'll trust in you alone. Yeah. And there's no prison wall you can't break through, no mountain you can move. All things are possible. And there's no broken body you can't raise, no soul that you can't save. All things are possible. Darkest night, you can light it up. You can light it up. The God of revival. Let hope arise. Death is overcome. You've already won. The God of revival.
You're the God of revival.
Make this your prayer. Come awaken your people. Come awaken the city. Oh God of revival, pour it out, pour it out. Every stronghold will crumble. I hear the chains hit the ground. Oh God of revival, pour it out, pour it out. Come awaken your people. Come awaken the city. God of revival, pour it out, pour it out. Every stronghold will crumble. I hear the chains hit the ground. God of revival, pour it out, pour it out.
The darkest night,
the darkest night. Light it up, you can light it up. The God of revival,
let hope arise.
Let
I just want to speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind. 'Cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus.
Yes, we do. I just want to speak the name of Jesus till every dark addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. I speak Jesus. Your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name is light. Break every stronghold. Shine through the shadows. Burn like a fire. I just want to speak the name of Jesus over fear and all anxiety. To every soul held captive by depression, I speak Jesus. Oh yes, I do. Your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name is light. Break every stronghold. Shine through the shadows. Burn like a fire. Your name is power. Yes, it is. Your name is power. Your name is healing. Oh, your name. Your name is light. Oh, yeah. Break every stronghold. Shine through the shadows. Burn like a fire. Shout Jesus in the mountains. Jesus in the streets. Jesus in the darkness. Over every enemy. Jesus for my family. I speak his holy name. Jesus.